In a parents and teachers general meeting at Kagadi Secondary School today, parents expressed concern over many teachers not being on government payroll, yet the school has over 2,500 students. In addition to inadequate facilities like teachers' quarters, classrooms and laboratory equipment. According to parents, Kagadi Secondary School is the only government-aided school in the district with 20 teachers on government payroll out of the 96 teaching staff. Parents have asked the Ministry of Education and the Office of the Prime Minister to intervene, asking government to put 76 private teachers on payroll and provide necessary scholastic materials to the school.
The staffing here is understaffing of the teachers on payroll. We have 93 teachers, but out of the 93, only 20 are on government payroll, which is causing expense to our parents, because it is the parents now paying the rest of the teachers, and thus bringing the expense, raising the expense of the parent. Therefore, I call upon the government to come in and help us, give us more teachers, put them on payroll such that we are relieved of the expenses we are facing.
Buildings are coming up, teachers are there, except our humble appeal to the government is that let the government employ these teachers who are not on government so that they teach our children the way they are doing it. Let the government have sympathy for them. And the teacher have put a lot of mechanism in place, and we are appreciating as parents. Now, the challenge we are having, especially me as a parent of three children, school fees is becoming a problem. Okay, we are not paying school fees, but the little we are trying to give to school to push our children, where we are getting the money, as per now, is very difficult.
The director of studies at Kagadi Secondary School, Biarugawa Tofield, implored parents to join hands with teachers at the school in guiding and counseling them amid challenges of inadequate facilities.
As we meet teachers and all stakeholders in education, I encourage everyone to work together, to cooperate. For example, parents should gainfully involve their children into something that will not make their children fail to come back to school. They should see to it that learners are still in line with education, not going into bad peer groups that will teach them something that will not make them fail to come back to school. They should encourage them to read their books alongside other economic activities that will help the family to go on properly. Then they make sure that on the day of beginning, that is the 5th of September, they all come back to join school when they are in good health condition.
Harriet Kemigisa, a senior woman teacher, expressed concern over the high number of school dropouts.
Girl child, the ratio is very high. You find in lower classes like senior one, the number of girls is very high compared to boys. But as you go into the upper classes, the number of girls reduces. It is worse in A level. For example, you find a school of like 3,000. In A level, only you find 78. Then boys are above 190. That challenge has been common in most of schools.
Report compiled by Andrew Musinguzi for the news.